elected official involvement at all.
She ready for a ride?
And most parades around the country, there are civic parades if people who are representatives walk in them, but they don't speak to them. They don't. It's not about them. Let's see what happens next year. Trump's now laid a predicate for him being the center of it. I'm sure he'll try to do that again next year. That'll be an election year. He's already caught a one-minute little video that you can see on his personal account.
Hey, this is Brian Williams. Thank you so much for listening to MSNBC on TuneIn, and stay with us all day for continuing live coverage.
And now back to live coverage from MSNBC on TuneIn Premium.
In 2020, among them Senator Kamala Harris, who, along with calling Donald Trump a predator, shared exactly why she says that she had the credibility to take him down.
I've had a lot of fights, most of which I've won. I know how to fight. And let me tell you, we're going to also need somebody who can successfully prosecute the case against another 4 years of that administration. I know how to do that.
Senator Harris, along with Senator Elizabeth Warren, saw their stocks soar in new national polls after the first presidential debate. A Quinnipiac poll that was released just Tuesday showed Harris surging 13 points since last month into second place, only 2 points behind frontrunner Joe Biden. That after Harris challenged Biden over his comments about working with segregationist senators and his opposition to federally mandated busing in the 1970s. When asked which candidate did the best job at the debate, 47% said Harris, and she was followed by Senator Elizabeth Warren with 17%. Only 6% said that former Vice President Biden had the best performance. And when asked which candidate has the best policy ideas, Warren took the lead with 31% compared to 19% in April. Sanders came in at 18%, while Biden received 11%, a drop from 23% in April. Despite these numbers, Biden remains the nominal frontrunner, even if barely, and the changes in the standings in the race are re-upping the question of whether America is finally ready to elect a woman president. There are now 6 options, most of them more politically experienced and savvy than Trump. So if not now, then when? Maya Wiley of the New School is back with me. Also joining now is Rashad Robinson of Color of Change, Tiffany Cross of The Beat DC, and Dean Obadala, host of The Dean Obadala Show on Sirius XM. I'm going to go to you first, Rashad, because I just ran into you last night watching Missy Elliott here at the Essence Festival 25th anniversary. Hey! And so I'm wondering if you had a chance, I don't know when you got here, but I don't know if you had a chance to walk around and have conversations with people that you're running into down here at Essence. Tell me what you're hearing. Is the Kamala boom resonating in the real world, or is this just us people who are obsessed with polls?
I think it's a mix of both. I think it's one, it is people that are obsessed with polls, and those of us in the political class who follow these things are sort of deeply invested in looking at the upticks and the downticks.